Could this top WWE star be heading to All Elite Wrestling? And the date is set for CM Punk's AEW return. But first, Jeff Hardy would make his All Elite Wrestling return last night on Dynamite when he came to the aid of his brother Matt, as well as Hook and Isaiah Cassidy, who were on the end of a beatdown by the firm. Well, today, Fightful Select would provide an update on the immediate future of Jeff, who has been away from AEW television since his DUI arrest in June, having since undergone rehab. Despite his return, it looks like Jeff isn't quite ready for in-ring action at this stage, as according to the report, he is still physically recovering from a recent unspecified surgery, and there are some alternative plans over the next few weeks that don't involve him wrestling. There is no word on exactly what the surgery was, and no specific time frame given on his recovery, although it looks like he could be staying at ringside for the time being, perhaps with an eye on a match at Double or Nothing in a few weeks. And speaking of AEW Dynamite, are you tired of waiting for AEW to launch their own streaming service in the United States? Well, using our Fight affiliate link, you can sign up for AEW Plus, a service exclusive to certain international countries, which provides you with the entire catalogue of Dynamite and Rampage on demand from episode 1 until now. It only costs $6.99 a month, and you can catch the shows live and ad-free. But what if you don't live in the countries that AEW Plus is available in? Well, you can also use our NordVPN affiliate link, an app that allows you to place yourself in pretty much any country in the world, letting you access AEW Plus no matter where you are in the world. So head to the description where you can find links for both AEW Plus and NordVPN, the perfect combo for any AEW fan. Vince McMahon would recently make his return to WWE as the chairman of the board, this before facilitating a sale of the company to the Endeavor Group, the parent company of the UFC. Following his comeback, an SEC filing would emerge that revealed McMahon had once again become an employee in WWE, with him set to serve as executive chairman for 2 years from his start date of January 9th, 2023, which is when he came back. Well, as part of this contract, there appears to be a non-harassment clause, as according to The Hollywood Reporter, McMahon's continued employment shall be conditioned on compliance with WWE's conflict of interest and code of conduct and their equal opportunity and non-harassment policy. This follows Vince's initial retirement last year when several sexual misconduct allegations and hush money payments came to light, which saw him step down from his duties for several months. It appears that Vince now finds himself on thin ice, as a return to his alleged old ways will see him out of the door. At WrestleMania 39, Edge would take on the demon Finn Balor inside the Hell in a Cell, with it being announced ahead of time that he would be returning to his roots from his days in the Brood, with him being billed as Brood Edge. This led to speculation that he would be joined by the group's leader Gangrel during their entrance, although as we know, this wasn't to be. Speaking on Reffin' It Up with Brian Hebner this week, Gangrel would be asked if WWE reached out to him over an appearance at Mania, with him responding, "They may have discussed it, but my phone never rang. I started reading all this stuff, people were calling me, so I wrote to Adam, Edge, do you know how this started? He made a joke, these writers think they know everything. I laughed, I tried to tell a guy to tell them. No, I wasn't doing it, but he still ran the story anyway. He goes, to be fair, it was pitched, it just never happened. It was pitched, but I never heard about it. I didn't know anything about it. They never reached out to me. I guess Edge is always pitching something for me. I think he pitched SummerSlam for me, but it got shot down." With Edge regularly pitching ideas for Gangrel to show up, it could be something we see in the near future, which would be his first appearance in the company since 2007. And speaking of Edge, his WWE contract is coming ever closer to its expiry date at some point this year, with the rated R superstar seemingly planning on retiring once SummerSlam heads to Toronto in August. With that said, there's been online talk on if he could show up in AEW once he hangs up his WWE boots, something WrestleVotes would discuss with Give Me Sport this week. When talking of the possibility of one last reunion for Edge and Christian, with the latter currently working in All Elite Wrestling, Give Me Sport noted that if this were to happen, it would be a surprise to many in WWE, and they would note, If he retires this summer in Toronto, I wouldn't be surprised. I would be surprised if he finishes his current deal and then goes to AEW. WWE would be surprised too. Even though you've got the Christian factor, you know, they could team one more time and wrestle each other one more time. I'd be surprised if he wrestles past WWE. WWE would be very surprised as well. And before we continue, why not drop a like down below if you're enjoying the video and subscribe to the channel with notifications turned on so you don't miss the latest wrestling news as we try to reach 50,000 subscribers by the end of the year. But with that said, let's get to the next story. And next, All Elite Wrestling today announced that the June 21st episode of AEW Dynamite, which is the final episode before the Forbidden Door pay-per-view, will go down in Chicago, Illinois at the Wintrust Arena, this 4 days before the Toronto pay-per-view. The news of course sparked immediate speculation of a CM Punk return, with this coinciding with a recent Fightful report that not only was he pushing for a comeback, but that he had made several storyline pitches including with and without the Elite. Well, it looks like the Chicago return speculation has some steam behind it, as Fightful Selective released a brand new report that reveals that tentative plans are in place. It should first be noted that nothing is set in stone, with there being room for change. However, it's looking good if you're one of the ones hoping to see the straight edge superstar continue to be All Elite. So to begin, Fightful noted that after their recent report about Punk pushing for a return was published, their sources immediately began to hint that the wheels were already in motion. They were then told that the 21st of June Dynamite would be an interesting one, this shortly before it was made public that it would be taking place in Chicago. Fightful then revealed that as of today, the working plan is for CM Punk to return at that show, or at least somewhere in and around that time. There's even been pitches for AEW to announce his appearance ahead of time, although as of now, that is yet to happen. As for potential rivals, the report adds that CM Punk is hoping to work with Kenny Omega and the Young Bucks to turn the real-life fight into an angle, although as of now, there's been no known contact between the two parties. It even appears that as of last time of checking, the Elite are not keen on the idea due to what happened at All Out. It was also revealed that Punk did push for a meeting between everyone involved in that situation, although it's unclear if progress has been made on that. It was confirmed that another meeting was scheduled, this time between CM Punk and Chris Jericho, who have had their own issues in the past, with the intention being to set up an on-screen feud. The report concludes by noting that as traction grows on an upcoming Saturday AEW show, the belief within the company is that this move is designed to create a soft roster split in order to separate the two sides of the locker room that may have issues with each other. Talent that Fightful spoke to have heard the discussions about a new show, but haven't heard about CM Punk's possible impending return. And in summary, the plan right now is seemingly for CM Punk to make his AEW return on June 1st in Chicago, Illinois at the Wintrust Arena, which is of course in his hometown and the same crowd that gave him a more than hero's welcome upon his return to wrestling at the First Dance back in August 2021. And before you go, make sure you check out the truth behind CM Punk's secret wrestling returns before AEW.